everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And today we decided we would do an aerial garden tour. Now, I am not a person for heights. I am shaking my knees right now, standing near the edge of the roof. But I'm willing to do it. It sounded like an interesting perspective. So we just wanted to let you see what it looks like from above, since we don't have a drone yet. And we'll use our roof as our drone. We first wanted to show you our main driveway. This is at the front of the house, and it leads over to our north garden. But right behind me, that large tree you see behind us, is our corkscrew willow, or snake willow, it's also called. And that replaced our huge maple that was here when we first moved here, that we had a swing in for our children. So this is a climbing tree, and it has served us very well. Now, another tree that you see right here is our weeping cherry tree. And you can see that there are some vertical branches that are sticking out. It's trying to imitate my hairdo. So those vertical ones we will be taking off, because they don't seem to weep over even if we let them get long. Also is my traditional zinnia garden, right below that fluff of fiber optics there. And you can see that the willow casts a lot of shade, so we have a variety of plants that like shade, except for that one little, well, it's not little, it's a giant hardy hibiscus there that does its best even though it's in the shade.
Now you can see the roses behind. I see a lot of your liatris, your hostas.
Mm-hmm.
And we decided that was what, a decorative or a ornamental?
Well, that's a flowering cherry,
flowering,
but it's not
cherry.
Weeping.
Right.
Right. And then that little fluff of red down there next to the whirligig is our Japanese maple. It's a fern leaf Japanese maple that is doing extremely well. And next to that, well, behind that is one of our peach trees. And then to the right of that are our heritage birch. And you can see the little alpine spruce that Rick has topiaried because they got burned by the winter sun and wind. And then you can see that kind of a chartreuse colored bush that is a sumac that was not supposed to be invasive. But to the left of it, you see a new little one there that shouldn't be there.
Well, it gives you a different perspective of our berms, too. And we've talked about this many times before, that this entire berm, which is now at least, I'd say, 20 feet wide and, I don't know, maybe 100 foot long.
Oh, I don't know if it's that long.
Well, you figure that's at least
it goes around the corner.
That's at least a third of a football field, if not more.
True.
All of that is just from leaf mulch and grass clippings.
Right.
There's no soil that really was brought in there, other than maybe the potting soil
for when we actually potted a plant before it was decomposed. And you can see the stepping stones that our neighbor gave us, the ones the dogs like to walk on so they don't get their feet wet. I'm going to hold on to you, Richard, so you don't fall.
Oh, sure. You want to push me over.
This is the very front of our porch where all the hostas are, and our Miss Kim lilac, and our Sub-Zero
pansies
that are still blooming. And over in the corner where you see the yellow black-eyed Susans and the liatris is our butterfly garden.
And then you've got your tricolor beech tree there in the middle.
Yes.
And then going over to more birch.
Then we have a river birch and a maple and another river birch.
Yeah. Yeah.
And behind it, that little cascading mound of darkness back there, that's a lilac tree.
Well, let's go over to the side of the roof.
Okay. Off to the south. Now, we showed you the hardy hibiscus that was in the shade. This is the one that is in the sun. This one is almost 6 feet tall now. And next to it, on either side of it, are two more hibiscus. They're not the tall ones, but they're getting there.
Yeah.
This one, I believe, is going to be pink.
Right.
And that one is kind of a reddish pink.
Right.
It's a beautiful
one. We can already
one.
See it in the leaves. It's more of a reddish leaf structure.
Yes.
And then, of course, our original peach trees, which have been trimmed back multiple times.
Right. They are loaded with peaches. Yeah. And then also...
But look what's down below.
Aren't those interesting?
Wow, I wonder what those are. I bet some of our viewers know what they are.
Purple, orange, and red.
My goodness. How did those appear? Oh, and there's a blue one over there, a purple
one. And a red one. Mm-hmm.
Hi, all these little
all these
surprises.
Little secrets.
And of course, right behind that.
Right behind the river birch.
Behind the river birch, you see that little splash of red.
That's our free library.
Free book library,
yep.
Right.
And then on this pergola is a very large honeysuckle vine that for years we thought was a trumpet vine. We couldn't figure out why it didn't have any orange flowers. Then we finally figured it out.
How about your clematis?
And then the clematis is just going to town this year. It's very happy.
I mean, look at all those blossoms up
mm-hmm.
there. When we think we've had this plant for decades and it never blossomed over by the south side of the garage. Amazing.
It wasn't in the right microclimate.
And of course your workstation
and my
down
potting
there.
Station yeah. and my little plants that are in pots that I'm...
And your mason bee and leaf cutter bee houses.
Yep, yep.
And then of course beyond that is the strawberry bed and all
mm-hmm.
the peonies
yeah, you can
along,
just barely
along
see
the
that
road.
One, right. And then this tall tree next to the pergola is the Bradford pear, which is not a good pear, but it's pretty.
That's the one that's split.
Yes.
And we anchored it with a bolt system. I know some of our viewers said, cut it down. But, you know, being an experimental eclectic garden, we thought, let's give it a try and see what happens.
Right.
Now, this maple tree.
This was the original.
This has been here for at least 40 years now, if not more.
Yeah, it's got to be 55 years for sure. It's a beauty. We're still looking southward, and this, is a shady area because of the pear and the maple, which we are now kind of right under the maple. This is a nice view of this maple.
It is.
I don't think I've ever been this close to that maple. But lots of hostas, a variety of them. And again, these don't seem to be bothered by the slugs. I don't know why. I'm thankful, but I don't know why. Our rhododendrons are over beyond...
They're really doing pretty good this year, although
they are.
With all this rain we've had, I'm just wondering if all that sulfur hasn't just been leached out of the soil already.
Well,
we're going to have to give it another treatment.
And see that very hardy, bright green weed there? We are still trying to figure out what that weed is.
Yeah, and I mean, it appeared this year probably more than ever.
Yes. Yes.
And then, of course, the original South Garden.
Yep. And you can see zucchinis and butternut squash and cabbage and eggplant and beets.
This is a really interesting view. I'm kind of glad we're up here this morning.
Well, and it's cloudy, so that's nice.
Uh-huh.
It's cool. There's a breeze. If the sun were out, I'm sure we would be in the mid-80s because it's very humid. So it's not nice. Again, this is a shade area, so we have lots of coral bells. In the urn here, I planted an elephant ear and a bunch of little flower seeds. I don't see a whole lot of flower seeds coming up.
They probably were washed away with all this rain.
Probably. But the elephant ear is happy.
Yeah.
And now you can see behind the trunk of the tree, you can see our tree peonies, our little nursery for tree peonies, and beyond that is kale. And
how about your garlic?
Then garlic that's it's getting ready.
It's
you can
getting
see.
Close. Yeah.
You can see the bottom leaves are turning yellow. And it's right about time. I think last year it was the mid-July that we started taking them down. And this is our little pathway of gravel that wanders through our little rose bush that we didn't think was going to make it this year because it was just so
It looked dead.
Looked awful, and yet it's struggling along and doing well. So.
Well, you chopped out a lot of dead branches
that
were in there too.
I did, and I can see two more I need to take out. But then we have different lilies over there. A row of lilies here. That little clump in the middle there is a Japanese iris that are done. Some bloom flowers. A bird bath from our neighbor. This is climbing spinach that we ate last year, and it started producing seeds, and the seeds sprouted, so I kept them all winter in the in your office. Here's my pergola, which you can see needs a lot of paint.
Well,
I really need to get out here and paint that.
Well, how can you? I mean, it's been raining at least every other day.
Well, it either rains or it's just way too hot for me.
I mean, it's been ridiculous this year.
Right.
I know some of our viewers have just given up on their gardens.
Yes.
You know, it's just crazy. And then, of course,
there's the big pond.
Cleaning out the pond. What an adventure that was.
Mm. So you can see where the leaves are bigger here. We didn't get to that part. Where the leaves are smaller and younger, where there's a flower, that's all new growth. And then that blue is also a clematis that's growing that we didn't know that's what it was. This is another hibiscus. Tim, those are your
Magellan
zinnias that are doing very nicely.
Really nice.
I
think they like this rain a lot.
Yes. Surrounded by some marigolds. Yeah. In the back part of the pond there, that's all going to be marigolds.
That upper level?
Yep.
Yeah. Well, again, this originally was a three-tier waterfall. It started at the top, obviously, went into the main area, because we used to have a huge sycamore tree there that we cut down and decided to build above ground pond.
Right,
and
to hide this stump.
Left extra liner in there.
And then there's still some giant bleeding hearts that I never have had a chance to chop down yet. Yeah. And then a ground cover that we planted, I don't know. I think that's going to be one of my projects. Because somewhere in there were three azalea bushes. We're now looking west. This is our west boundary here. And my never-ending weed project the other day that we did a video on. Again, more bloom flowers. Couple of gargoyles,
Oh, you got mums, you got chickweed in there, is that
no,
tickweed?
No, that's coreopsis.
Coreopsis,
that's what it is.
Okay.
And here's my lupins that are doing so well, and I'm finding little lupins in many places, so I am very happy. Yes.
Upper waterfall.
And then the Solomon seal that we planted there this year. And then you can kind of see a perspective on what the giant fleece plant looks like there. Now I've chopped, you can see the right side I've chopped so that I could get into that area to weed. The wagon is waiting for a nice kind of weather, not too hot, not rainy, so Rick can rebuild our toadstool benches.
Yeah.
And then we're looking off toward the northwest.
Well, let's
where
go up onto this part
garden.
Part of the roof take a look at it from there.
Very good. We're a little farther north on the roof, still looking to the west, but we wanted to point out the ginkgo tree. I mean, this tree is just one of our all-time favorites.
I love the leaf structure of ginkgo. It's considered one of the oldest trees.
Yes, it's from China.
Yeah.
And we had some visitors the other day that were from Korea, and they were just so surprised that we had a ginkgo tree and that they even grew in this climate. So they were very appreciative of it.
Yeah.
Knowing that it's one of the oldest trees in the
think of all the viewers that you had who said in fall because it the leaves come down.
Yeah, well, the whole tree turns yellow, and it'll stay yellow, a bright yellow, for the longest time, and then we'll have a hard frost, and within 2 days, all the leaves will drop off at the same time.
It's like being in a yellow snowstorm.
Yes, and it'll be all over the ground. One year, our grandson Logan was here, and he was just delighted. We were raking them up into piles, and he was jumping into this yellow, golden yellow pile of leaves. It was
great fun.
Well, I was about to say, think of all the viewers who ask, could you just put all those leaves in a bag and send them to us?
Let me chew on a few.
But now you can see the Liberty Garden that's to the back of the garage here. A plum tree there. Our bat house that's up in the post. And if you can see that very, at the very top, there's a hole on the left side of the tree. That served as a nesting ground for northern flickers.
This gives us a great bird's eye view of the Liberty Garden.
And you can see how the flower seeds seem to be doing better than the carrots or the lettuce. Lettuce is really surprising us. That's a tiny little green next to those pots.
Yeah, I'm amazed.
Can't figure out what's taking them so long. The beans are doing well on the end. But again, this is a compost bin from Built Right with Rick's structure over the top waiting. Rhubarb, our neighbor's lilac tree, which we enjoy. This is a plum tree. Another Alberta spruce. Some daylilies over there, an echinacea, and a rattlesnake master. That's where that is. And then we move over. That's a pear tree we planted years ago.
The little one in the raised bed?
Well, the big one.
Oh, the big one.
And then the little one we also planted. That's a pear. Neither one of them are great producers. Rhubarb, tomatoes, more tomatoes. Behind the tomatoes are our peppers. And then we have our nursery gardens there. And then we have our perennial garden with strange flowers growing in it.
This gives a better look at my little nursery garden where I'm starting things. Now we're talking about the second bed. There are Montauk daisies that I have finally figured out how to expand on them by just snipping them off and sticking them immediately into the ground. They don't like to be rooted in water. They just like to go right into the ground. They're doing very well. To the left of that, the kind of a brown didn't work so well. Those were tamaracks. I don't think I had watered them enough and the weather was just too hot.
What do you mean, haven't watered them enough? Nature's been doing a lot of watering on its own.
But there were days when there weren't, and who knows. To the left of that, I'm trying the same thing with forsythia cuttings. They look a little bit droopy now, but I'm hopeful. And in the back, you see kind of purplish ones. Those are purple leaf smoke tree or bush. I'm trying the same thing with them. And then way, you know, on the very edge are some of our little tree peony
hybrids
that we bought at a peony show and planted, and they survived the winter, and so they're about this tall now. So 1 year old. The birds love it here, and we love them. And you can see our painted allium, which are strange flowers over there. We've only put a few of them out. We're saving them for special occasions.
They are, huh? And even your raspberries beyond that.
Yes, you can see tiny little raspberries that are growing. Next year we'll have more.
Yep. Well, we had a couple this year from ones that survived.
And then this massive green bush here is a Rose of Sharon. It's another hibiscus. Blooms, you know, is starting to get the bloom heads on it, so we're looking forward to that.
Now we're looking eastward, and if you look directly down, this is our kitchen window that looks out onto the red Japanese maple, the topiary alpine spruce. You see a lot of greenery in there. That's wild geranium and some more hostas. Coral bells of different colors, and our picnic table. So you can kind of see, there's our willow tree again, so you can kind of see the perspective. Our main driveway, and then that lovely tree over there is a linden, a little leaf linden. It's beautiful shape. And there is our iris bed that we did last year in the 90 degree weather. And the hostas we found after we got it done.
I just saw a little bird going to that little...
I thought I did too.
He's got his little head sticking out right now.
Yay!
So they're using that as a nesting ground.
Cool.
All right. Yep.
Yep, there you go.
And then, of course, beyond that is where we had the grape arbors.
Right.
The raspberry jungle, which is no longer there.
Right. And so. Then over to the left of the little leaf linden, sticking up in between there is a contorted pine that's kind of struggling for sunlight. And beyond that is our one and only ash tree that we have left.
It's a cimarron ash, I think.
Yeah. Right. And then you can see the start of our, that's my new perennial garden behind the red trailer, and then our northern vegetable garden. We're kind of looking back at where we began. When we were standing on the roof at the beginning, we were right over there to the right of the flag. That's where we started. So it gives us a different perspective of where the kitchen is, where the snake willow is, where the picnic table is, and how it looks going down the driveway.
I always thought it was go west, young man, go west. Why are we facing east?
That's the way our driveway goes.
Oh.
We hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give us a thumbs up. It helps support our Wisconsin Garden blog, and it lets us know that you appreciate and find our videos helpful. That house next door is about to go up for sale, so if you know someone in the Brookfield area that will love to live right next to Wisconsin Garden, keep your eyes open for it.
Do they have to be from this area? Or could they be from out of state?
California, even.
There you go.
If you have comments or questions, we'd love to hear them. We always love to hear what's going on in your garden and in your part of the country or the world. And we truly appreciate that you are watching and letting us know about what you think and what's happening. If you'd like to become, you can't become part of our garden family unless you go to our website.
Well, you can. I mean, you know, just by supporting, giving us a thumbs up, that does it. But if you want to watch our videos, now that YouTube got rid of its annotation feature for videos, they have it for cell phones, but obviously I'm not recording on a cell phone.
But you can still subscribe.
Oh, yeah, you can subscribe.
You can still subscribe. Okay, you can become part of our garden family by subscribing.
Yeah, we just don't have a little button on our videos anymore.
No.
Oh, well, times are a-changing.
Yes, they are.
So I think it's time for me to change my pants now that I'm up here on the roof.
Yes. Why, are you scared?
I am frightened to death. Yeah, right.
Bye for now. Oh, mosquitoes are out.
Connect with us on YouTube.